Hi everyone, I'm Andy and today I'm taking you to Gwangjiang Market, just a short walk from Jongno Samga Station. I've been to this market when I visited Korea many years before and I want to show you some of the cheap and excellent things that the market has to offer. You won't be disappointed, so let's go. This is one of the main entrances, but I'm not going to go through here. Just to the right is a small entrance which leads to the first place. Just walk through here, it's literally 10 seconds away. Looks pretty unassuming, right? Well, you'd be wrong to miss this one. At first glance, you can see they serve Odeng, but they have more. If you pay for the 4001 set menu, you'll get 3 dishes which are pretty excellent. Let's see. First up, you have the Odeng. There's 2 small sticks, which is perfect for me. You also get a dish with Japchae and Kimbap. I can't believe it's 4001. Not only that, but you can also grab a paper cup and fill it with Odeng soup, which is a kind of fish-based broth. Trust me, it's delicious. Kimbap time. This kimbap appears to have some of the usual components. There's radish, egg, surimi, pork, and tuna spread on top of the rice. Oh, that tastes fantastic. I feel it's value for money already. Okay, let's try it with this chili. Oh yes, not overly spicy, but it adds an extra dimension to the taste. Wow. Look at the japchae. I think it's pretty simple, but that's all you need, right? Well, it tastes okay, nothing special, but I'm happy with the price so far. Let's try the broth. Oh, the broth tastes great. It's hot and rich in flavour. Even though it's a warm day, it tastes somewhat refreshing. Yum. Odeng's always a favourite of mine. I wonder how this one stacks up. Oh, perfectly cooked, and the taste of the stock has been well absorbed into the fish cake. Delicious. Well, that was Gwangjiang Market. Thanks for watching. What? You want more? Okay, I'm feeling generous today, so let me show you some more stuff. At the other end of the market are a couple of more places I want to show you, so let's go. This place is pretty popular for their bindae dok, which is a mung bean pancake. I came here some years back, but I've forgotten how they stacked up. You know, stacked up? I'm ordering one of the pancakes for 5001 and some gogi wanjia, which is a type of pork patty, for just 3001, altogether around £5. Wow. This is gakdagi, a kimchi made from radish. It came for free, so it's delicious by default. I'm going to try the pork patty first by putting it in the soy and vinegar dip. It tastes amazing, it's so well seasoned and the dip gives it a hint of sharpness. Brilliant. Let's try the mung bean pancake. Oh wow, now this is awesome. I can't believe they give such a large portion for such a cheap price. It's lightly crispy on the outside with enormous crumbly texture inside. and it's perfectly seasoned. Thank you. Ready for a bit more? I am. I want something sweet now, and I know just the place. Come this way. No, sorry, the other way. This place is also well known for its donuts. They serve a few types, but I'm just going to try two of them. One of them's a Quebeggy, which is a twisted donut, and the other's a, let's say, a black glutinous rice flour donut. Let's try the Quebeggy first. It feels warm through the paper cup and it smells great. The queue seems to never end, and I think that's partly down to the price. It only costs 1,000 won. It's absolutely lovely. It's crispy on the outside with a chewy texture, and I love it. Just look at how it's all twisted inside. I've made these before, but never as good as this. Beautiful. This is the black glutinous rice flour donut. For the size, it's a little heavier than I was expecting. There's an interesting texture on the outside, and it looks a bit funny actually. Let's try. Wow, as soon as I bite into it, it seems to deflate. It has red bean paste inside, and it tastes both crispy and chewy at the same time. I prefer the other one, but this one's nice as well, and it costs the same, just 1,000 won. So try it, you've got nothing to lose. Anyway, I'm off again. Let's go to this place, a Tucson place. It's just across the road, so let's go in. Tucson place is what I'd consider one of the nicer cafes. They seem to specialize in cakes, so if you're ever looking for a birthday cake, then this is the place to go. Their drinks are pretty nice too, so I'm ordering a large iced latte and a regular iced Americano. Regular, large, medium, large, medium. Regular, super small, small. Oh, this makes no sense. I've also ordered a little pistachio macaron as well, which costs 2,200 won, about £1.50. I'll try it in a moment, but first the iced latte. Ah, that was just what I needed. The coffee tastes great and I'm finding it refreshing on this hot day. Perfect choice. How about the iced Americano? It's not the cheapest at 4,500 won, so I expect great things. It's not bad, it's on the fruity side, which is what I like the least, but you can tell it's good quality. And look at those ice cubes. Back to the pistachio macaron. It was expensive, so I'll savour this. I can definitely taste the pistachio. It has a thin crispy outside and it's soft and chewy in the middle. Very chewy. It's probably worth the price actually. I'm enjoying it. All 20 seconds of it. Is Tucson place worth it? Yes, it's pretty nice, so make sure you visit. You won't be disappointed. I always say that, but you won't. I'm not done yet. I want to check out this antiques market at Dongmyo and find one last bite to eat. This market has a little of everything. It's pretty crazy. Look at these bags, 3,000 won. I don't think you'll find Chanel or Gucci, but you can't argue at the price. Oh, what are these ancient things? Who cares? Just buy them, they're cheap. Well, I could do with a rice cooker, or just stuff in general. I'm in heaven. This door here is where cables come to die. I think I have a drawer at home that looks like this. This is the last stop, No Brand Burger, which, ironically, is a brand in itself. I think they hint at being reasonably priced, but the prices don't actually seem amazing compared to the other fast food joints. I'm going for the signature set menu, which is 5,600 won. That's about £3.50, which isn't too bad actually. This is cider. It's not the British cider that you're thinking of, it's more like lemon and limeade or Sprite. Refreshing. And here's the beef burger. It looks pretty standard, but look at the back of it. They just shoved a whole lettuce in there just to annoy me. Let's try. Actually, it tastes okay, but the main problem we're having is the lack of texture. The beef patty is almost mushy. It's a bit weird if I'm honest. I'm a bit disappointed. The fries? Well, the fries are delicious actually, but I'm only having these because of the set menu. I probably wouldn't come here again as I wasn't impressed with the burger itself. A shame. So that's me done for the day. I'm completely stuffed, but I had a great time. Thanks for watching. Until next time, bye!